Blythswood Care is a Christian charity whose head office is in Evanton in the Highlands of Scotland. In 2014 marks the 21st anniversary of the annual Blythswood Shoebox Appeal. I visited Blythswood in Evanton to find out more about the Shoebox Appeal and how to be involved.
Hi, I'm Stuart Gardner. I'm with Blythswood and I'm the Shoebox Coordinator. The Shoeboxes are really quite an exciting project for Blythswood. They aim to ship out 120,000 shoeboxes to a lot of needy people, not just children but teenagers and adults as well. And we ship out to countries, for example Romania, Moldova, Albania, Serbia and even to Pakistan. And we've got places around the country where these shoeboxes are sorted and then eventually packed into lorries and off they go to their destination, most of them before Christmas, for these people to receive them. And we've got to remember that these folk who are receiving them are people who are, in our terms, really very poor. And to get these shoeboxes with all the gifts and the items in them is a great excitement for them.
The general public plays a vital role in the success of the Shoebox Appeal.
My name is Cathal McCaskill. I'm the Deputy Coordinator of Blythswood for the Shoebox Appeal. The Shoebox Appeal is unique in many ways in that we are totally dependent on the public for everything we receive.
The involvement in this project is vast because we are pulling in shoeboxes that have been lovingly made and put together by people in the whole country.
In all, over 100,000 boxes are filled, all by volunteers, and that work is carried out in a number of search stations right across Scotland and into England. And we're hugely appreciative of the time that is given up by people in all parts of the country to make the Shoebox Appeal a success it is.
The shoeboxes is our main object. We love it. I just love doing shoeboxes. Shoeboxes brings a smile to so many people's faces. Not just you for making a box, the person who's checking the box, the person who's giving the box out at the other end, and the person who receives it. That makes it for a lot of happy smile faces.
Oh, well, I'm Joan Wells. I've been working at Blythswood as a volunteer for about 17 years, and it's changed quite a lot from when we first started, because we've got this nice new, comparatively new warehouse now, and I've been doing nearly always just sorting clothes, which is quite important because the clothes go out to the shops for sale. We get on very well with the bosses, and they're very kind to us, and they give us plenty of time off for coffee and things. So we're very happy in our jobs here, and it's something I'll go on doing as long as I can.
Making your own shoebox at home is a simple task and hopefully is enjoyable too. I asked some friends to talk about their shoebox making experience.
My name is Melanie. I'm an RGE student. I study computing for graphics and animation. I've decided to do the Shoebox Appeal today because Claire approached me about doing it, and I haven't done it since primary school. And I thought it would be a good opportunity for me because, well, in primary school you didn't have as much freedom to do to choose what you put in your boxes, and now I do today. And I want to do it for a 7 to 8 year old because I have a little sister. And I think it would just be really nice because I know how happy she gets and her smile really makes me happy.
Hi, I'm Gemma and I'm an accounting finance student and I'm currently working for Shell. I first heard about the Blythswood Appeal when I was about 8 years old and we made them in brownies as part of guiding. And then I hadn't made one for years until recently at my church they were handing out leaflets about it, so I decided I'd make one this year.
I'm Maura Charnley, and I've been doing Blythswood shoeboxes for about 10-12 years now. First heard of it through our own church and through the kids' schools.
Hi, my name is Maria Ivanova. I'm 21 years old and I come from Bulgaria. I am a second year media student in Aberdeen, and I heard about the Blythswood shoebox appeal from Claire, which interested me a lot, since it's great charity that allows you to send gifts to children, for example in orphanages or in foster care, and I was interested in it mainly because it also sends shoeboxes to Eastern Europe, that's where I come from. I really like the idea, and that's why I'm taking part in it.
Now I'm going to wrap my shoebox.
Blythswood asks that you wrap your shoebox in Christmas wrapping paper. It is important to remember that these shoeboxes may be the only items that these people receive for Christmas. When choosing your shoebox, it is important to make sure you get a regular sized one, not too small and not too large. This is to ensure fairness when the shoeboxes are given out to people. Blythswood provide a checklist of items that are essential for the shoebox and suggested. This is to guide you when you're buying things to put inside it. Some essential items include a toothbrush and toothpaste, soap, or a small toy for a child. A hat, gloves, and scarf are also on the essential list. These items can provide much needed warmth in cold winters. Kitchen utensils, small tools, or household candles are perfect to include in an adult shoebox. You can also buy stationery. For children, this could include crayons and colouring books. For older children or adults, it could include pens and notepads.
Okay, so the first thing is a really nice, in my opinion at least, a doctor set from Disney. I thought that was a good present since I'm doing the box for a girl that's aged about 4 to 5 years old. I thought everything for girls is pink. So I thought that was more of a neutral gift for a child. Then I've put some other required stuff, that was a toothbrush and toothpaste. A further thing is a glow wand, Mickey Mouse. Then we've got one of the required things as well. Those are, I thought that was really cute because it had owls on it. So that's for the hands. And then there is a small crown, princessy crown. Cinderella on it. Then another required thing was a hat for the winter because it can be really cold. And then last but not least is the scarf, which again has a cute owl on it and has feet. So I thought that was really sweet for a child. Yeah, that's how it goes in. Everything. Then we close the box and it will get to a lucky child somewhere.
So I've made my box for a girl between the ages of 3 and 7. I included just sort of the standard stuff that it asks you to, which is toothbrush, toothpaste, hat, scarf, gloves, soap, and a small doll, but I've gone for a pony. I've also got things like a crayon, as well as just sort of like sweets and soap and stuff like that, so sensible things. So I've gone for sort of a mix of stuff that they both need, but also just nice things that you would like to get at Christmas. So I hope that she likes it.
My box is for a girl aged 7 to 8 years, which is my sister's age. So I've chosen things that, well, mostly I see her using. So I've got a coloring book and it's got loads of animals, things, bunnies. So that would be first. Another toy I've got is a wee dolly. Got pencil case full of pens and pencils, and also a wee dolphin sharpener, rubbers. So that's that one. also got things that I really need. So, underwear and face cloths, a hairbrush, strongly fit in now, toothbrushes and toothpaste, a wee notepad, and some jelly beans to match the box. So my expectations for this box is, well, families need like necessities like the soaps and toothbrushes and things. The toys and hats and the sweeties and things will be basically their Christmas, so they'll have something, some toys to go towards their Christmas.
I do it because it's a nice thing to do at Christmas time when you're spending a lot of money and lots of other presents. It's quite nice to take time to think of other people, and you know, it's nice to put the boxes together, think about what you're putting in it, think of the joy that, you know, somebody else that's not got much is going to get. It's a good thing to do.
Now that you've completed your shoebox at home, it's time to drop it off at a collection point to be taken to Blythswood for the sorting process to begin.
I'm Ian Matheson. I'm the operations manager here at Blythswood, and I have responsibilities for all the commercial activity of Blythswood, so all our shops and all our recycling. But I have oversight of the warehouse where all the shoebox sorting is going on right now through this month and out to the various places.
I'm Judith McKenzie. I'm here at Blythswood's Deephaven headquarters, and I'm here to help set up the shoebox sort station. We've got a good number of boxes beside us, and in a few days there are going to be quite a number of people coming to help to sort the shoeboxes and get them ready.
It starts in earnest in September, around about September, October, when a lot of the shoeboxes are prepared, and in early November the sort station's open for business.
The particular sort that's starting here at Deephaven is for Hungary, and the project that Deephaven is sending to is called the Good News Foundation in Hungary, which initially was run by Charles Fisker, but it's also now being run by members of his family, and they provide help, aid and all kinds of good things for the Roma people and the poor people in their area. And in respect of the shoeboxes, the general public donates the contents of the shoeboxes, from toiletries to scarves and hats and warm clothing, underwear, shampoos and face cloths and household needs and many other things. And Blythswood itself provides the literature. For instance, a child would get a children's book, and the book is written by Karen McKenzie of the Christian Focus Publications in Inverness, and the teenage book is suitable for youngsters up to 13 to 19, and the adults, say the men, the women and the elderly folks, get calendars in their shoeboxes, and everyone gets a compliment slip, and in the compliment slip it says, say in their own language, the verse in John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whosoever believed in him would inherit eternal life." And that is the content of and the provision made by Blythswood itself. We also have great numbers of donations of fillers that we can add to some of the shoeboxes, because perhaps if a child fills a shoebox in school, it's not full to capacity. So if there's a space in the shoebox, we're able to put more into it. And that's when we're dependent on the volunteers to come and do the finished exercise.
The sort stations are manned by volunteers, some who have been doing it for a number of years, and without their help there would be no shoebox appear. It means a huge amount to the recipient, the people in the recipient countries. In some cases, for both adults and children, it may be the only gift that they ever receive during their lifetime. Which is in sharp contrast to how Christmas is viewed in our home country.
So I don't know who's going to see this video, but if you're in any way inclined to contribute, either this year or next year, then that would be fantastic. Just get in touch with Blythswood and we'll tell you what to do. So thanks a lot.
Sending a shipment of shoeboxes to a country is expensive for Blythswood. And so if you do not have the time to make up a shoebox yourself, you can donate to help the cause. If you would like to find out more about Blythswood, take a look at their website or their Facebook page. I hope that this video has informed you about the work of Blythswood and has inspired you to make your own shoebox for the 2015 annual Shoebox Appeal.